Hence, on today's session, we are looking at the lab session. Specifically, we are looking at the hematology, the field of hematology. Okay? And then we are looking on the red blood cell indices. Okay? So, as we've been doing the procedures, this helps us as clinicians because, one, as we said from the beginning, we say that hematology is both a lab science and both a clinical science. So, how it comes to clinical science, that's where we make a decision on how to make a diagnosis and plan how to manage. How it comes as a lab science, that's where we do the procedures such as laboratory and then also the issues of the testing procedures. Now, we are looking at the red blood cell indices, meaning we are trying to concentrate on a test which we call full blood count. This is a test where we are able to check all the blood cells, which includes the red blood cells, which also known as erythrocytes, also the white blood cells, which is also known as leukocytes, and then we have the platelets, which is also known as thrombocytes. Okay? Now, when we talk about the red blood cell indices, meaning we are interested first of all to look at the red blood cell. Okay? So we look on the red cell count and then the hemoglobin concentration. And then from there, we are going to look at what is called the mean capacitular volume or the mean cell volume. And then from there, we have the mean cell hemoglobin or the mean capacitular hemoglobin. From there, we are looking at the mean cell hemoglobin concentration. And then we are looking on the red cell distribution width, which is abbreviated RGW. Okay. Now, a procedure that I want us to look on is how do we diagnose anemia? Okay, as clinicians, it is not enough just to know anemia. Because why? Anemia simply means lacking of blood concentration altogether. So, meaning the capacity of oxygen carrying is being reduced. Now, we want to know what is causing the reduced concentration of hemoglobin. So, a procedure as a clinician, first of all, you start on hemoglobin. So, hemoglobin is a determinant where you have three questions. One, is a patient having anemia? Or, is a patient having the normal concentration of hemoglobin? Or, is a patient having much concentration of hemoglobin? So, in this case, let's assume to say the hemoglobin is low. Okay? So for us to understand how do we know hemoglobin is low, first of all we have to look at what's the normal hemoglobin in an adult. Okay? So we have adult there, we have the male, we have the female. Whenever we just write female, we are saying non-pregnant. Okay? Then we have the pregnant. Of course, we may have even a child, a neonate. Okay? So for male, we have 12 up to 18.